Okay.
And we're trying not to do any closures on C because it's going to be such a short span that we're going to occupy that space. You know, an hour and a half, maybe at the most. So I thought we'd do advisory letters for those residents that we used to open the doors, letting them know that they would have some problems in the morning, let's say 8:30 to 9:30, in going in and out of their driveways because the street's going to be full of parade vendors.
So the parade isn't actually going to drop C Avenue, it's just going to form on C.
Exactly.
We'll start forming down by the sale barn down in that area.
I don't think we'll have to go that far down.
Okay.
We don't want to have to cross the highway completely. We think that's just a real dangerous thing to do. So we're going to line up on C. Sales barn's not available, as I said.
Right.
And I don't think we're going to take up much of C.
Okay. And you're going to go up to Highway 1 and back over to B?
And south and then come up B.
Just so I know, so I can get the stuff.
Right.
So B Avenue and Fifth Street, do you want them closed on Friday and Saturday, or just Saturday? Before, it's been just Saturday.
This year, we also have Friday night, which includes the fun run, and there's a live band, there's a dance, food vendors and everything are already in place starting at 5:30 Friday night.
5:30?
So if I put 4 p.m. Friday to 10?
Well, I wish I had my paperwork with me. I
didn't set 2 p.m. 2 p.m. to 10 p.m.
What does he have on there? I didn't see that.
I think we allow them to start setting up at 2 p.m.
I'm sorry.
And then Saturday, 7 a.m. to 10 p.m.
Yeah. And this has been on good by the chamber. I mean, you represent the chamber. Yeah. They said they'll close office. They'll close those streets off at 2 p.m. on Friday.
Yes.
Okay. But the Friday closing is only downtown. We're not closing the part of the highway.
No, it's downtown.
Well, the only one we'll list that we're going to close more than the time for frame for the parade will be B Avenue at Fifth Street.
B Avenue and Fifth Street, yeah. That's all of downtown.
Which is 4th Street to 7th Street. And then at Fifth Street will be A Place to C Avenue.
We'll put up signs like we always do. Don't park for the parade.
Okay.
Okay.
Do we want to make that a resolution for next?
Yeah, I'll have it ready for next. Okay.
So let's do on the time for the request. Do you have any other updates, David, on the base?
No, it's just that it's going to be much larger than it was last year. We already have 25 vendor booths registered. There's going to be activity, like I said, Friday night. The race will now take place, start to finish downtown, instead of at the park. That way it gives more of a celebratory feel for the runners when they finish. There's going to be live music, food's available, dancing's available. So it's more of an event for Friday night for the run also. Then Saturday goes from 9:30 to 9:30.
Is it a live band and?
Live band both nights.
Yes.
Performing on your stage.
Okay.
The box trailer.
One update that you'll enjoy, we're not moving tables from the park this year.
Thanks.
We're renting.
So we can go ahead and make a park reservation on those shelters in?
Absolutely.
And I hope there are lighter rack tables also. The second part of that request.
Yeah, I think we should just express appreciation for the council, to Dave Finley and Susan for all the effort they're putting into really making the Kalona days go.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for what we're doing. There's a lot of activity that wasn't happening a few years ago, and I think you're doing a good job of organizing and making it go.
Thank you. our board.
We taught him everything he knows.
Just bad stuff.
The second part of the request is item B, a fenced in area on Fifth Street for selling beer by Paula and Ward Miller. Custom Brew Grill on Fifth owners. The request to, at that, I suppose that's on Friday night?
Friday and Saturday.
Two nights.
Is that, are you using part of the street for that, or just?
Yes.
You are, okay, so we'll close the street.
The street be fenced off and secured with officers.
From where to where?
Well, from the alley.
Where are you fencing?
From the alley portion, how far do you want to go, Dave? So probably from the alley up to the corner past Yachty's and the attorney's office, if that half a block there.
The whole street, or would we have a fire lane?
Well, we could keep a fire lane if they need one. The booth or the trailer for the entertainment's gonna be against Yachty's building. So you certainly need sidewalk open so people can go on the west side, I would think. And you can leave part of the street open, the fence can be done however you want it.
I've already talked to fire chief, he said if they have to, they'll get there one way or the other. We always talk about fire lanes, and then a lot of times we don't do it. I hope we don't need it.
Alley has to stay open and the street has to stay open. On the opposite, your alley. And the street has to stay open on the other side of the road. At least one lane.
So just 10 feet of the street?
You're saying he can't go from his building, we can't put the fence clear to Yachty's building?
Yeah, you can't, no, I'm saying east west.
That's what I'm saying, he can't go from the east side of his building to the west side of Yachty's building? We can't take the fence all the way across the street?
You can. The avenue has to stay open.
Right.
And the alley has to stay.
Right, okay.
Now, does this have to be a motion or a resolution or what does? They're gonna have to apply to the alcohol beverage division for a special privilege.
It's coming.
I think you have to have a special one.
Our insurance man knows, and if you just don't have it in front of us now.
I mean, because it's gonna be separate from your regular liquor license. And then we'll need to have a drawing and everything exactly how you're gonna fence the area in and ask to.
We'll do that.
The license requires that, right? Didn't they?
Yes.
You have to map it out already?
Well, their patio areas are mapped out.
They haven't asked us for that.
Is there any reason why we can't approve it dedicated on them obtaining a proper state approval system?
Do they need insurance?
They'll have to.
We have insurance.
Insurance certificate? Maybe that's the initial insurance. The map. And the permit.
Which, don't you have to have the map to get the permit?
Yes.
She said no.
Well, you know what, Gary never said we needed that, but.
We'll find out.
But we can do that. He's talked to them twice, thinking he'd have it for us today, but. And there's no problem, it's just that they're very busy.
They're probably only working 4 days a week. Kauffman days, what are the Kauffman before that, as long as they know they're behind them?
Give it off to the general?
It's gonna be on the next time because you're gonna have to approve the permit. Yeah, because it has to go through the alcohol beverage division.
You know, council's behind them on this, it's just a matter of the formality of having the right paperwork available to us to approve.
There's time between next.
Right. And I'm hearing that you guys are gonna be running through.
Next meeting for June 1st, you for.
Even the second meeting. Second meeting.
Well, yeah, that's gonna.
So we're telling the warning party that you're gonna.
Yes.
Okay. So we won't take any action on that until we have the permit, it's got to be addressed. You know, I'm hearing that, every night.
Okay, good.